Good evening and welcome to Campfire Worship here tonight at Trinity. Feel free to listen or sing along with this prelude as people find us for worship tonight. I love you, Lord, and I lift my voice to worship you, oh my soul, rejoice. Take joy, my King. Welcome to Campfire Worship. This is our prelude as people find us for our service here tonight. I love you, Lord, and I lift my voice to worship you, oh my soul, rejoice, take joy, my King. Welcome to Campfire Worship here at Trinity Lutheran Church in Watertown, Minnesota. My name is Pastor Jeff Engholm. I'm grateful to be here with you tonight. I'm also grateful that Robin Behrens is with us tonight behind the scenes operating all the technical stuff here that helps us put these services together. Also thankful that you all are here today. If you're with us here, check in below there. Click one of the buttons there or put your name in there or just say hi to us. And whoever else is here, because we're all here worshiping together. If you want to see a bulletin for tonight, you can go to our website, trin.org, and go down to our online worship, and you will find where a bulletin is. You can follow along in print, although you don't have to have that tonight. I'll just lead you through everything we're going to do tonight with our simple songs and simple prayers and simple campfire worship here tonight. We continue to be figuring out how to worship in this place together. I know we're not all physically here together, but we are all here together in this way. And I've learned something new now lately. I know that a number of folks are gathering with family and friends out and about, wherever you are, worshiping with this service as the core of what you're doing. I know a lot of churches are trying to kind of gather inside their building and kind of grow it from the inside out. But what would it look like if we grew our worship experience, people physically together, not from the inside out, but from the outside in, and you with your people as you wanted to, whoever you wanted to be with, having pockets of people here worshiping and over here. So instead of going from the inside out, we go from the outside in. And they have more and more people gathering, and pretty soon, well, when the time is right and it's safe, we will be back under this roof. But in the meantime, you could be under God's big roof in all kinds of worshiping communities, wherever you are. I wonder what that would look like. Maybe we'll find out in the days ahead. Regardless of what that's going to look like, I'm grateful that we're all here right now together. As we wrap up our series on the fruits of the Spirit, we've been doing this for the last 9 weeks. Now it's 10, looking at the fruits of the Spirit. Our opening song is about the fruits of the Spirit, about the orchard that all the fruits are in. But it's not talking about an orchard. It's actually talking about a garden. So we'll use our imaginations. I mean, gosh, if this can be a campfire, well, then this song about the garden can also be about the fruits of the Spirit. Inch by inch, row by row, gonna make this garden grow. All I need is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. Inch by inch, row by row, someone bless the seeds I sow. Someone warm them from below till the rain comes tumbling down. Pulling weeds, picking stones, We're all made of dreams and bones. Feel the need to grow my own till the time is close at hand. Grain for grain, sun and rain, find my way in nature's chain. Tune my body and my brain to the music of the land. Inch by inch, row by row, gonna make this garden grow. All I need is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. Inch by inch, row by row, someone bless the seeds I sow. Someone warm them down. Plant your rows straight and long, temper them with prayer and song. Mother Earth can make you strong if you give her love and care. Old Crow watching hungrily from his perch in yonder tree. In my garden I'm as free as that feather beak up there. Inch by inch, row by row, gonna make this garden grow. All I need is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. Inch by inch, row by row, someone bless the seeds I sow. Someone warm them from below till the rain comes tumbling down. Till the rain comes tumbling down. We have a reading tonight about the Lord who walks with us during these strange days, during these days of the wandering in the wilderness, which we are still doing, feeling a little bit like we're in exile, away from our homes, even though we can see them and things look familiar. Everything's different. And so as we wander through this, we remember that God is with us, bringing us comfort. A reading from Isaiah chapter 40. Comfort, O comfort my people, says your God. A voice cries out, in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youths will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. This is the word of our Lord. As we think about our Lord calling us to the Lord's table, this table of worship, it's a table of grace, and it's a table of peace, and it's a table of joy that our Lord invites us to. It's not my table, it's not your table, it's God's table that we gather around here tonight. You're invited. Come to the table of grace. Come to the table of grace. This is God's table. It's not yours or mine. Come to the table of grace. It's a table of peace. Table of joy. Come to the table of joy. Come to the table of joy. This is God's table, it's not yours or mine. Come to the table of joy. Here's a responsive reading from the book of Psalms, Psalm 136. I will say a line, and after each line, you will say, "Lead us through the wilderness, O God." O give thanks to the Lord, for his steadfast love endures forever. Lead us through the wilderness, O God. O give thanks to the Lord, who made the heavens and the earth, who made the sun to rule over the day, who made the moon and stars to rule over the night. Lead us through the wilderness, O God. O give thanks to the Lord, who brought God's people out of captivity, who divided the Red Sea in two, and who led his people through the wilderness. Lead us through the wilderness, O God. O give thanks to the Lord, who rose from the grave to bring new life to all creation. Lead us through the wilderness, O God. And here's a reading from the fifth chapter of Galatians. Let us not become conceited, competing against one another, envying one another. Those who belong to Christ Jesus have crucified the flesh with its passions and desires. If we live by the Spirit, let us also be guided by the Spirit. And the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Grace and peace to you from God Almighty, the one who calls us to fruitful living and changing lives. Amen. Did you see what I did just there, just now? Fruitful living and changing lives. Usually, when we use that phrase around here at Trinity, we remind ourselves that God has called us to faithful living and changing lives, which is true. But tonight we're reminding each other that God has also called us to fruitful living and changing lives. Not that different, of course, but I want to focus on the fruitful living because we're wrapping up our Fruits of the Spirit series here at our campfire services. Over the past 9 weeks, we've looked at each of the 9 fruits of the Spirit that are listed in the book of Galatians. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Each week, we have looked at one of those fruits and dug a little deeper into what each fruit is about. For instance, when we looked at love, the very first one, we thought about love as being about 4 things for each of the letters, L-O-V-E. We talked about love being about listening, being open, valuing each other, and endurance. The next week, we talked about joy, and we actually did the same thing, J-O-Y. Joy is about Jesus, others, and you. You get the idea. Of course, we didn't break down every single word like that. I mean, it would have taken forever to get through faithfulness, F-A-I-T-H-F-U-L-N-E-S-S. Now, that wouldn't have worked. But we did talk about what faithfulness is about, along with all the rest of the fruits of the Spirit each week. By the way, if you missed any of those and you're curious, they're still posted on our website. You can just go there and you can go back and check those out if you're interested. But tonight, we sum it all up. And I just have, one last thing to say about all these fruits of the Spirit. Think about this image. Sometimes, in the fall especially, when I'm driving past an orchard or a grove of trees, maybe I look out and I see those beautiful, bright red apples on those apple trees. They're just gorgeous to look at. I just want to take a picture of the perfect apple on that perfect apple tree. Capture that image in my mind and just hold it there. Here's another image. My daughter lives out in California. Right in her backyard, she has these luscious lemon trees. They're beautiful. When I have visited her, looked at those bright yellow pieces of fruit on those trees, I just want to leave them there. Don't touch them. Don't mess with them. They're just so beautiful to see all that. I could say the same thing for all the beautiful, colorful fruit trees that I have ever seen. Don't touch them. Don't mess with them. Leave the fruit right there, just where it is. But then I remember that the fruit on those trees, that fruit wasn't just put there to look pretty. Apple trees, lemon trees, cherry trees, peach trees, what have you, all that beautiful fruit didn't grow there just to look at. That fruit grew on those trees to be harvested. That fruit grew on those trees to be shared. That fruit grew on those trees to be passed around so people could be fed. It's just like the fruit that you bear in your own life. The love that you have inside of you isn't just there for you to feel good. And the love you have isn't just like between you and God. The love that God has grown there is a fruit of the Spirit, and it's meant to be shared with others. The love you have, the joy you have, the peace you have, the patience, the kindness, the generosity, the faithfulness, the gentleness, the self-control, all of that, it might be beautiful, but God didn't grow all that fruit of the Spirit in your life just to leave it there. So it's there just for your sake, so that you could just kind of live at peace, so that you could kind of feel a feeling of love all by yourself, maybe be joyful all alone. The fruit of the Spirit that God is growing in you is meant to be shared intentionally by you, reaching out to others even when they can't reach out to you. It's about being kind to others even when they can't be kind to you. It's about being patient with others even when they can't be patient with you. Here's one very last thing about fruit trees. You know what happens to trees when they give away the fruit, the apples, the lemons, the peaches, the cherries? You know what happens when all that fruit's given away? The trees simply do what they do. They grow some more fruit. You know what happens when you give away your fruits of the Spirit, your love, joy, peace, and all the rest? God just grows more of that inside of you, more to fill your life, so there's more to give away. Because that's how God works, filling your life so that you can fill the lives of those around you. That is what the fruits of the Spirit are all about. Amen. May the peace that passes all understanding keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Amen. All that we have, all that we are, is all meant to be given away. Kind friends all gather round, there's something I would say. What brings us together has blessed us all today. Love has made a circle that holds us all inside, where strangers are as family, loneliness can't hide. You must give yourself to love, if love is what you're after. Open up your hearts to the tears and laughter, and give yourself to love, give yourself to love. Love is born in fire, it's planted like a seed. Love can't give you everything, but it gives you what you need. Love comes when you're ready. Comes when you're afraid. It'll be your greatest teacher, the best friend you have made. You must give yourself to love, if love is what you're after. Open up your hearts to the tears and laughter. Yourself to love. You must give yourself to love, if love is what you're after. Open up your hearts to the tears and laughter, and give yourself to love. Give yourself. Speaking of giving ourselves to love, it's time to share the love and share the peace. You know how we do it here? We share the swag, S-W-A-G. We smile, wave, and greet each other So whoever you're with there, smile, wave, and greet them. And if you're just on your own, smile, wave, and greet me here. Hi, I'm waving at you and all of you. And guess what? Rob is waving right now there to everybody on here. Yes, she is. She's doing it. We're all saying hi to you. We're passing the peace, sharing the love. We're doing it now. And don't forget to share it later on. Someone's waiting to hear from you right now as you give yourself away. Send somebody a text, an email, a letter. Give them a phone call just for no reason at all. Help us all stay together during this time. And now it's also time to collect an offering. You know, the most important offering is you, yourself, and your own life. So thank you for sharing your life, giving yourself to love, giving yourself to the love of those around you as you bring that. But I also want to say thanks for the financial offerings that are brought here. Thank you to those of you who drop them off here, who come here in the mornings and actually bring us an envelope. Thanks to those of you who are mailing them in. We're grateful for that. And thanks to those of you who are learning to share your financial gifts online. If you're curious about how to do that, how to share a financial gift online, just go to our website, trin.org/give. And there'll be all the instructions you need about sharing a deposit from your bank or sending it by text or however you want to do that. But most importantly, I simply want to say thank you for all the ways you support the ministries of Trinity Lutheran Church here and around the world. Let us pray. O Lord, support us all the day long of this troubled life, until the shadows lengthen and the evening comes and the busy world is hushed. The fever of life is over and our work is done. Then in your mercy, grant us a safe lodging and a holy rest and peace at the last. Amen. We pray together as our Lord has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. We continue to make our way through this time of the COVID-19 and health uncertainty. We continue to make our way through this time of economic uncertainty. We continue to walk through this time of civil unrest as we work hard at living our lives together. And we continue to celebrate all the things that we celebrate as God's people and as the people of this country. This weekend is the 4th of July celebrations. In honor of that, here's a song that goes way back to before the Civil War. It's a song to be sung once the fighting's over, once the battles are done, and we vow to not ever do that again, to find other ways to live lives of peace. Join me on the song as you know it. I'm gonna lay down my sword and shield down by the riverside, down by the riverside, down by the riverside. I'm gonna lay down my sword and shield down by the riverside, down by the riverside. I ain't gonna study war no more, ain't gonna study war no more, ain't gonna study that war no more. I ain't gonna study war no more. Peace down by the riverside, down by the riverside, down by the riverside. I'm gonna walk with the Prince of Peace down by the riverside, down by the riverside. I ain't gonna study more no more, ain't gonna study more no more, ain't gonna study that war no. over. Not now, but we will one day again. You know what I mean? I'm gonna shake hands around the world. Down by the riverside. Down by the riverside. Down by the riverside. I'm gonna shake hands around the world. Down by the riverside. Down by the riverside. I ain't gonna study war no more. Ain't gonna study war no more. Ain't gonna study. Thanks for joining me on that song. Thanks for joining us here tonight. Let's pray our closing prayer. Guide us waking, O Lord, and guard us sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep we may rest in peace. Amen. Go in peace. Serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Don't forget, this Sunday morning, we'll see you at 9 o'clock. For our Sunday morning worship, and between now and then, have fun and safe 4th of July celebrations, however you're doing that. And as you're doing everything in your life, stay calm, stay connected, and shine on. I'm going to lay down.